A potential divider is a simple but very useful circuit, which allows you to obtain a lower voltage from a higher voltage source by using just two or more resistors. In this video, we explore the potential divider and see how easy it is to build a potential divider circuit. Let's start with just two resistors. Connect two resistors of the same resistance in series and connect them to a power source. For me, I'm using a 5V power source. Taking a voltmeter reading across the entire circuit gives me 5V. But taking a reading at the midpoint between the two resistors gives me half the voltage, or approximately 2.5V. How do we arrive at that value? Turns out, it is the ratio of resistances that create this effect. I'm currently using 220 ohm resistors. However, if we were to replace both resistors with 1 kilo ohm resistors, the reading in the middle is still exactly the same. Again, this is because the voltage generated is a ratio of the two resistances. So now, let us change up the ratio. Using a 220 ohm resistor alongside a 1K1, we create a reading of about 4.1 volts. How does that work? Turns out, the magic is still in the ratio, which can be calculated like this. The numerator of the ratio comes from the resistance under the point tapped, while the denominator is the total resistance between the positive and negative points. This ratio gives you a number less than 1. Multiplying that by the total voltage across the circuit, we get the resultant voltage. Applying this formula to the circuit we've just created, we can see how easy it is to derive the final voltage. By calculating the ratio and substituting our input voltage into the equation, we can very easily get at the answer of 4.1 volts. With the same logic, we can easily set up a potential divider using more resistors. For example, here's one using 4 resistors. By summing the resistances of the resistors below the point of contact and across the entire circuit, we can compute the ratio and use that to find the resultant voltage. A potentiometer is a simple component that allows you to easily build an adjustable potential divider. To understand why, we have to delve into its innards to see how it works. A potentiometer consists of a length of resistive wire in a coil. A rotating contact, called a wiper, makes contact with some part of the wire. Rotating the knob on the potentiometer allows you to adjust this point of contact. The resistance between the wiper and each end of the resistive wire changes as the knob is rotated. The further current has to flow across the wire, the more resistance it encounters. What this means is, at its simplest, we can use just two terminals of the potentiometer, causing it to act as a variable resistor. Turning the knob lets you select a different level of resistance. However, what's more interesting is how we can tweak this up for it to work as a potential divider. See it like this. You've got what is essentially two resistors of variable resistance within the potentiometer. The wiper will be your point of contact in the middle, supplying positive and negative to both ends of the wire completes the setup. By twisting the knob, we can smoothly change up the resistances, and thus as a result, the ratio between the two resistors. This gives us a simple way to adjust the output voltage. So, in summary, a potential divider is made up of two or more resistors between a voltage source and ground. A reduced voltage can be taken from the junction between two resistors. The voltage there can be calculated based on a ratio of the resistances. Here's a rule of thumb that could make things a little bit easier. If you were to treat the resistances as distances, then you could simply say that the closer you are to the high power source, the higher the output voltage is going to be. Conversely, the closer you are to ground, the lower the voltage would be. Thinking this way makes it extremely easy to picture the output voltage of a normal potential divider, and it also gives you a quick gauge on how to set up a potentiometer. You see, the usual behavior for control knobs is that, for whatever quantity you're controlling, the more clockwise you turn, the greater the value. Assuming this is controlled by a voltage, what the rule of thumb will tell us is that the positive terminal needs to be the rightmost terminal. We know this since, well, the further right the wiper goes, the higher the output voltage needs to be. So what this means is the wiper needs to get closer and closer to the positive terminal as we turn to the right. And that's why we set things up this way. Inverting the positive and negative terminals will cause the range of outputs from the potentiometer to be inverted. And that's it on potential dividers. I hope you've learned something today, but until next time, you're watching 0612 TV with nerdfirst.net. Thank you very much for watching. If you like my work and are feeling generous, you can shoot me a one-time donation on PayPal or sign up for a recurring one on Patreon. Of course, you can simply like, comment, and subscribe. You know the deal. For more videos, links to my channel and a related playlist are on screen. Thank you for your support.